Morning, sir. There are 112 men on parade in the open order. But when your disposal, sir, please. Stop!
Hooray! Gunner Wilkinson, Colenso troops up.
Load! Up!
Close order!
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. We'll now continue with the presentation of prizes for intake 9203. And the first prize is for the potted sports competition. And this trophy is awarded for a competition involving sporting skills, fitness and teamwork. And the winners are the Cateau troop.
Thank you.
Cowie Trophy. And this trophy is awarded for sporting ability in tug of war, football, rugby, running and the obstacle course. And the winners are Sphinx Troop.
Good soldiers,
perform and remain absolutely steady on parade when conditions are not so good. And you achieved that, of course. And I congratulate you. And no doubt also the fact that it rains will make sure you never forget that. I guess too, those people watching will also remember. Because they were on parade half an hour before you. And can I welcome all the families and friends and relations who've taken the trouble to come here today. You are a very, very important part of today. The fact that many of you have come long distances is even more welcomed by us. You know, whether you like it or not, a little bit of you have joined the Royal Regiment of Artillery today. Your role in the future remains very important. These young men are going to go out and join their regiment, but they need the support of you. They need someone to tell them. They need someone to listen to their long war stories, because whether there's been a war or not, you'll still get war stories. And you must listen with patience and turn them around and send them back like good boys. But it is very important. And I hope you will notice what has happened to them in the time they've been under training. That ability to perform on parade, that almost breathless performance of physical training, which shows how alert and ready they are for their duty. And I assure you that we, the Royal Regiment of Artillery, will look after them. They have joined a family, so will you. And I do hope that you will take time off to visit them when they get to their regiment. At this stage, I want to say something about your instructors. Now, there's lots of things you and I can say about that. But I suspect that just at this moment, you're a little bit sorry for the saying goodbye. Oh, no, listen to that. But I do want to impress upon you, you have here some of the most outstanding non-commissioned officers in the Royal Regiment of Artillery, with years of experience, and they have spent their time giving you that experience. You now have someone to model yourselves on in the early years of your career. And I have no doubt that you won't forget them easily, will you? And I hope that some of you have the ambition to be standing as instructors in future. Because most of them, I suspect, sat as you are now when they passed out here. Shall we allow them to stand at ease?
Yes.
Or shall we keep them standing for a
second?
What you have achieved. Well done. Some combination
fire and movement. The Royal Regiment produces the firepower, and that comes first. You will now go off and join one of the great regiments that form our regiment. They're all different. They have different equipment, they have different characteristics, they recruit in different areas, and they all, as regiments, have their own personalities. And when you join, you will get swept up in it. And soon, there will be no one better than your regiment, and your battery, and your troops in that way. And that is as it should be. But remember, too, that there are pitfalls. The army is not an easy profession. The army is a tough profession, a demanding profession. You are soldiers 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 52 weeks in the year. You're just as much a soldier when you're home on leave or when you are in Colenso walking out in the evening. Therefore, your conduct and behavior has to live up to the highest standards of your regiment. There are two things that could let you down, and I want to mention them. The first is drink. I suspect that if any of you get into trouble, it will be because of drink. What is more, drink will do damage to you, and you should not do it. You cannot be a good, alert soldier if you drink too much. Now, I don't mean don't have a party every now and again. I certainly don't mean that. And that's part of growing up and part of life. I have a strong suspicion there'll be some parties going on tonight. That's not what I mean. But not every day, not all the time. Keep alert. Keep on regular drinks. And the other one, which I'll mention very briefly, is drugs. They are not allowed in the army. And the army always spots the chap who misbehaves in their head. And that is the end of his career. And the reason is very simple. You cannot have soldiers with lethal weapons in their hands if they're not absolutely alert and know what they're doing. Enough of that. You will, however, have a lot of fun in your regiment. You are just at the start of your life. And you're going to travel. You're going to see new things, new places. You're going to do exciting things. Some of you are going to jump from aircraft in parachutes. Some are going to climb vertically up and down cliffs. I don't know what the bloody hell you want to do all this for. Some of you are going to travel around the world and do all kinds of things and play sport. Remember, the opportunities for sport are very great, especially in the Royal Regiment of Artillery. And sport is part of your training. It smartens you up, it makes you alert, and it keeps you fit. So whatever you do, have fun in that direction too. Now finally, remember to study your profession as soldier. Master what it is you are given to do. There is a golden rule as a soldier, you know. If you want to do something, or you want to achieve something, or you want to go somewhere, whatever you do, do the job you're told to do today as well as possible. And when you've done that, you can then ask to do something else. And if you don't do the first job right, you're unlikely to get the second. And as you earn confidence in yourself, be ambitious for your own future. You should be going around saying, watch this space. Because as I look at you now, I hope that I'm looking at a bunch of bombardiers, sergeants, sergeant majors, regimental sergeant majors, quartermasters, who know. It's up to you. You will be given all the help and assistance. If you play your part, no reason why you shouldn't get to the top of the tree. So remember, if you remember nothing else, you are a soldier. Your mission in life is to make sure that there is not a war, and you do that by demonstrating that we are ready for war, therefore no one will take us on. Remember that to do that demands service to your country and to your regiment and to your family. You become the true peacekeeper. Not these chaps who go about waving banners. If anything happens, they get under the stone. If anything happens, soldiers go out and put the fire out and restore peace, as was done in the Falklands and was done in the Gulf. And they conceivably have to be done to the Yugoslavia. You are to give your families and all mankind the things they need more than anything else, peace and security. That is your mission. So well done, congratulations, and the very best of luck in your career. I shall meet you as I come round your regiment. You can remind me that I took your patronage parade, and you can tell your regiment to push off while you and I have a chat. Thank you very much.